This video is a continuation of the series on the HPE 3-part volume plugin for Docker and our integrations with Kubernetes and Red Hat OpenShift. This demo will be done using OpenShift, which is a distribution of Kubernetes that is available from Red Hat, to create persistent volumes using the 3-part plugin. The volumes will then be replicated between two sites using pure persistence. We will also simulate an array failure and how the OpenShift cluster and application volumes will behave using the automatic transparent failover technology from Pure Persistence. Please note that even though we are using OpenShift in this demo, the concepts and commands are the same and should work within Kubernetes. And you can substitute the OpenShift OC commands with Kubernetes kubectl, kubectl, or kubectl, or however you want to pronounce that. And the commands should work the same. Before we get started with the demo, let's cover some of the prerequisites or assumptions in case you want to recreate this demo within your environment. The first and most important requirement is that you need to ensure proper connectivity and zoning has been configured between your sites and 3-part arrays. Also, if you're using Pure Persistence, a Quorum Witness will need to be deployed in a third site. Once we have the prerequisites out of the way, we can enable replication support within the 3-part volume plugin by setting the target array information in the properties file that is used for deploying the plugin. I covered the basic install process of the plugin in my previous video, which I definitely recommend you watching since I'll only be covering the replication specific parameters here. These replication parameters are found under the optional section in the plugin properties file. We will need to supply the following information. First, we'll specify a name for the target array. And if we are enabling peer persistence, we specify the Quorum Witness. Next, we set the replication mode depending upon your needs. So you could set synchronous for peer persistence, asynchronous or streaming for an active passive setup. You configure your CPG mappings here between the arrays. And then finally, you enter the target 3-part array's IP and username and password. Once these parameters are set, the plugin can be installed as normal. In case you already have the plugin deployed, you can configure the properties file as we did and rerun the installer to enable replication within the plugin. Now that we have replication enabled within the 3-part volume plugin, let's get into how to use it and demo a failover scenario. To create a replicated volume with OpenShift or Kubernetes, like with most volumes, we first need to create a storage class. In this storage class, we start with a name and specify the 3-part volume driver. And then we set any specific volume parameters we may need for our application, like custom CPGs, permissions, enabling compression or dedupe, QoS, etc. Next, we specify the replication group that this volume will belong to. This will ensure any volume using the storage class will be replicated and be part of the specified remote copy group. You can use an existing remote copy group here or create a new one. Once we are done creating the storage class, we can import it into OpenShift so that it is available to our users. Let's use the OC describe command to verify that the storage class was imported successfully. Now that we have our storage class, we can create a persistent volume claim. And in this scenario, we will just be requesting a small 25 gig volume for our mission critical web server. Let's import that PVC request, and we can see here that the volume has been created and is bound and ready for use. Let's go ahead and shift over to our arrays. If we run the show rcopy command, we can see the status of the volumes. Remember, we created the remote copy group called nginx-app, and here we can see that the RCG has been created on the primary 3-part 8440 and is being replicated to the target 3-part 7200. We can also run the same command on the secondary or target 3-part 7200 array and see that the volumes have been replicated successfully and are now syncing. Now that we have verified that the volumes are replicating between arrays, let's go ahead and deploy our Mission Critical web application. We've created an Nginx pod here that uses the PVC we created earlier with the replicated volumes. Now that that has been imported, let's verify that it is working okay by writing some data to the web server. We can also verify the sync status of the volumes by again rerunning the show R copy on the arrays. It looks like everything's checking out okay. Now we are ready to simulate a failover. In order to simulate this failover, we will need to block communication from the primary array to the quorum witness while at the same time taking down the remote copy ports. This is done by simultaneously blocking traffic via the firewall on the quorum witness and then turning off the remote copy ports on the 8440. Once we have this done, we can run the show rcopy command on both arrays to check the status of the failover. When we check remote copy status on the primary array, we can see that it is now reporting failed. The still active 7200 array is now showing the primary 8440 has failed. The role has also changed to primary-rev, as well as the syncing has stopped. With automatic transparent failover, all volume paths have also failed over to the secondary array, and it is now the primary site. If we look at the failed primary array, we can see that it is in fail-safe mode. Now let's check back with our web server. Since this web server is mission critical, we need to ensure that there weren't any interruptions. Since our web data was written to the persistent volumes, any interruptions in the data paths will have crashed the servers, but we can see that the web server is still working even after the failover. There wasn't any need for intervention to the application or to the OpenShift cluster in order to restore connectivity to the volumes. It was completely transparent. At this point, our trusty sysadmins have fixed the outage, and we can go ahead and start restoring connectivity between our sites. Let's see how the environment will react as we restore connectivity by unblocking the traffic on the quorum witness and turning the RC links back on the primary 8440. As soon as connectivity is restored, the primary and secondary arrays are showing a ready status. We are now able to resync the volumes from the secondary array to the primary. Once the sync is complete, we are able to restore the 8440 array as the primary array. Finally, we are able to check the status of our web server and verify that there weren't any interruptions during the failover and failback of the persistent volumes within our OpenShift cluster. This concludes a successful demonstration of how to use the HPE 3PAR volume plugin for Docker with peer persistence to enable protection and minimize storage disruptions to your mission-critical application data within containerized workloads. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this demo.